The word of God is alive and powerful, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of the soul and the spirit and the joints and the marrow. And it is a critic of thoughts and intents of the heart. All scripture is God-breathed and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God might be mature, thoroughly furnished unto all good works. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed. Rightly dividing the word of truth, or accurately handling the word of truth. How many lessons are there for us to learn from each and every word of the Lord through proper exegesis, isagogics, and categories of the explanation of the word, so that we could really know and understand what it is that our Lord has reserved and kept for us in eternity past. The word of the Lord, which is so much essential for us to know, that in Ephesians 5:24, it teaches to us everything in a proper order, proper manner, hypostaso. The doctrine of the church has to be placed under the mind of Christ our Lord. Likewise, the woman have to be under the subjection for a man. Many people might have understood it in a wrong manner, in a wrong method, in a wrong process. But divinely setting orderly everything is the mindset of hypostaso in the Greek. It doesn't go for being in subjection. It doesn't go for this or that. But rather it really teaches to us what it has to be in Christ. And that is what our Lord sets everything in a properly ordered manner. And that is what the church also has to be in a proper order manner. The church which has been taken around in a proper order manner is nothing but the way under the mentor ministry of Lord God, the Holy Spirit. He sets everything to the praise of the glory of Jehovah when we are taking in the word of the Lord day by day. And that process to be revealed in this mystery doctrine of the church age particularly, which is so much essential for us to know, that your attitude towards the word of the Lord shows how really you love our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. It is not that just accepting him to be our Savior or our salvation process, but rather, dear brethren, we are doing these things to a point to understand that how great are we really looking in upon loving our Lord without having proper accurate exegesis of the word and isagogics and categories with a dispensing technique of dispensations and being not aware about the knowledge of angelic conflict. You cannot have that love which is due unto the glory of Jehovah. You may be happy thinking XYZ reasons, but Lord doesn't look upon that. Our Lord looks upon only those things which pertains to Bible doctrine. And if those things have not been met absolutely, then you have lost. Dear brethren, these things are very much essential for us to understand. These things are our life. This thing is the process which our Lord has set for us in an orderly manner of hypostaso, being under set or being subject to the ministry of Lord God, the Holy Spirit, who really clearly delineates for us the mystery doctrine of the church age and rightly dividing the word of truth. And many much more lessons are there for us to be learned. Because of the fear of the wrath of anger of our Lord, the great nations, even the one who is having strength, will bow down before him to worship him because of his word. But we are not worried about those things. We are thinking, let the things happen as it may be. So I will have this filth upon my flesh, filth upon my soul, filth upon my spirit, and filth upon my each and every garment which I wear, and I will stand before the Lord. No, it cannot be, dear brethren. It is of a great lesson that you and I should know, should learn, should come. That until and unless you take number one priority to cleanse out the filth and stand purely for the word of the Lord, you cannot really take the word. And that is what many men will come to say in the pulpit, in the congregation. What is there? We will just keep filth in our mind, in our thought, in our word, in our deed. Why we need to confess those sins? With Lord deals only holiness and righteousness and purity. Without that, we cannot really worship and praise the great Lord. With our Lord deals only righteousness and in truth. And if we really neglect to know this truth, really fail to understand this truth, then you have gone. Gone for what? Gone the way how the people led into apostasy by stumbling, by not having proper word, by not having the real absolute standard or the natural sense or the spiritual sense of distinguishing and to get out of that snare, dear brother. This is of a very great lesson that you and I should learn. But many men do not value the word of the Lord, neither they are valuing the truth of Jehovah.
It is of a great pain for us to tell to you all these things again and again. But men love darkness rather than truth. Men love ignorance rather than the word of the Lord. And that is what it is happening today in our churches. Even the pastors are loving to be such kind of an extension, that they are so much degraded in their thinking, that they do not even value or think of what is the true word of Lord. With great pain and agony I am saying these things. I am not blaming you all, but you judge yourselves. I am not a one to judge you. But the time comes when the word of the Lord will judge you. That time you will not have to regret. That time you may claim to tell to the Lord, Lord, I have done a wrong thing, I have done this, I have done that, I would have done better. That time no chance for you. The escrow blessings, what they have been given and reserved and kept, you are going to lose it. You are going to keep them only in a hall of a film of a record, and they're going to, and you are going to see there. Many men do not understand about this unique spiritual life, the mystery doctrine of the church age. They have not really understood what is the word, what is the power of the word. Satan knows very well what is the power of the word. But we believers are not able to understand what is the true power of God Almighty in His teaching. Therefore our Lord said to the children, to the brethren, I am going to proclaim your name, and I have confidence that they will definitely take this crown and glory and safeguard it to the maximum honor at the judgment seat of Christ. But men have not understood these things. The only reason men have not understood, because they preach and they don't practice. But the order should be, practice what you preach. Or practicingly you preach. In the New Testament we are kings. In this unique dispensation given for us great information. What for? At least once you need to write the word of the Lord and make sure that there is none who are going to take away that crown. But people don't want to look upon this doctrine. Listening or reading to the word of the Lord alone is a great thing in their life. How and when they can sit and write, and preferringly upon the knees once. And if you are a pastor teacher, preferringly to write twice, once in the language of your original realm and once in the translation. But the problem is, their father is a pastor, the son has to be a pastor, the grandfather and the grandson has to be a pastor. Men have become more corrupted than the great corruption which I can find in my country, India. They have become to such kind of a great extension the corruption of the world, that they have exchanged to lie the truth. Therefore, dear brethren, we need to know very well, we are being justified by the word of the Lord, by truth. And apart from that, any other method, any other process is not valid. You need to be very cautious to know and to understand these things. As long as we fail to understand these things, your life is a meaningless one. So think over these issues as we shall come back and continue tomorrow. With our head bowed and eyes closed, the closing moment is being dedicated to those who are here without Christ, without hope and without eternal life. Inaudibly telling to Lord God the Father that you believe upon Christ, that is the moment itself you shall have this eternal truth. This eternal truth for is for very simple, believing Christ you shall be saved. Whereas for the believer, the great mandate is to grow up in grace and the knowledge of Bible doctrine. You shall learn to acquire to possess to know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. And for the pastor teacher, the great mandate is to keruso thon lagan, herald the word in season and out of season, because of the diamond from my witnesses where that you have been called. Number one diamond from my witnesses in the eternity, followed by Bible in our hands, and number two diamond from my witnesses over here. If there are no hearers, dear brethren, not worry. Besides nature, the entire angelic host will be our witnesses. But what is our prime work? Our prime work is to rightly divide the word of truth. So which way you want to go, as we shall come back and continue tomorrow. Father, we are grateful for the privilege of you and our fellowship in the word. We pray that Lord God, the Holy Spirit, generate us on these things and make us all the things that we suffer in the world. For they ask it in Christ's name, Father. Amen.